Amelie Sloan. I want to congratulate you on your upcoming show December 6th at 205 Lavinia Street, and I know it's going to be a wonderful turnout. You have a wonderful book that I just looked at that will be on sale there of your many faces in ceramic, and a couple of questions I have for you.
Yes.
How long have you been making art?
I've been making art since, off and on for a long time, but I've been concentrating on ceramics since I took a class with Dorothy Lewis in 1973.
And
a long time.
The subject matter you liked best while working in ceramics?
I like to do masks of different cultures because I'm interested in anthropology and decoration and history.
And what was the most exciting moment of your life?
The birth of my children.
Great.
I have three children.
Is there anything that you'd like to do in the art field that you haven't done already? Working with another medium, other subject matters, anything else?
I've enjoyed taking pictures of around Sussex County in the past, and I would like to do more photography.
So your next show will be one of photographs?
I think I'm going to stick with ceramics.
Ceramics.
Yes.
You have some beautiful masks, and I can't wait to go to that opening at 205 Lavinia Street and see your work. And it was wonderful, wonderful talking to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Maurice.
For inviting us into your home. Thank you. But tell me the story of this one. How long ago did you do this? That's in the book, isn't it?
I think so. Yes. Now that was inspired. Actually, I had this exhibit catalog, and it was from the Moche civilization down in Peru, northern part of Peru. Mm-hmm. And they had an exhibit out in California some time ago. And these people did very interesting pottery. And they'd had a lot of jugs that had these faces on them. And they also had other kinds of pottery that told the story of their hunting and their fighting and all kinds of things.
Now, there's no glaze on this, right?
No.
This is...
Now, after it's bisqued, mm-hmm. I take a Barnard clay, which is sort of a slip clay, and I learned how to do this from Dorothy Lewis. She took... Every time you take a class, you learn something. So, she said, if you put this wash on, which, after it's bisqued, it's clay and water, and then you paint the wash on, then you sponge off everything you can get off, so it remains in the wrinkles and in the features of your piece.
So this blush.
So it's sort of a kind of antiques your piece.
Oh, I'm Anne Frances Eldridge Harris. I was born in Pensacola, 1918, when my father was away in service. And he didn't see me until I was 18 months old. I grew up in Falls Church, Virginia, and moved to South Georgia, the famous Okefenokee Swamp. My father was a forester, and this was private lands, 250,000 acres. And so for 6 months, the five children got to live in this fabulous country. I mean real country. The children we went to school with started using snuff when they were eight, and they brought their lunch in a lard pail, you know, and they were just, and they were without shoes, you know. But they were so entertaining. They knew the name of every frog. They knew where the bear came when it was time for the bear to come out. In the summertime, we all went to special places, each one of us to a different place, to get some really good social connections. I went to Pensacola and stayed with my two aunts and took piano lessons there. And by the time we reached New Orleans, I was beginning high school, but I went to the Ursuline Academy. that was right across the street for music. You know, my grandmother gave me the color yellow.
How did that happen?
Well, she said I look better in it. She and she said, if you wear yellow, you always sunshine. And when I would wear yellow, I would feel like sunshine. I feel like sunshine now.
Eugene Bookhammer, how are you today?
I'm still alive.
Are you still alive? Yeah. That's good. I'm glad. This is a privilege of interviewing you because you know very well I'm a good friend of your daughter's. Give a little secret away. Your age? 90 years old, correct?
Well, that's what they tell me.
90 years old and looking like you're 73. That's amazing.
That's a compliment.
You look good. You look good. No, we're going to keep my age a secret right now. I want to mention, first of all, that's the reason why we're here, is that you're having a photographic exhibit at 205 Lavinia Street, correct?
I understand that's what we're working
on. A photography exhibit with a very well-known illustrator, book writer, Ann Harris. Now, I hear she's 92. How do you feel about sharing the spotlight with another artist?
Let me tell you, I can't believe it. I think it's quite a privilege to me, rather than more than her. She's been in it that long.
She's been in it a long
time.
She's
still doing it.
I'm going to ask you something, because I know the art you're going to be showing is photography. How long have you been doing this photography thing?
Oh, a very short while, only since the first of the year.
How did that happen?
Well, my friend, girlfriend, gave me a nice camera, beautiful camera. I never had used a camera like that before.
Ever? First time?
Well, not like that one, I was sure. It's a really modern thing, you know. I don't know that much about it, but I take pictures anyway.
Now, somebody told me something about school. Did you go to school with this photography before or after? Are you doing some schooling with this?
No, I didn't go until I got the camera, and she was looking at the University of Wilmington, and she saw where they were having classes, photography classes, and she signed us up.
Now, I hear you have a collection in Lewis, a collection of photographs that are on a wall. Can
yeah.
you tell me something? How did that happen?
Well, I've been acting very much interested in BB Hospital, and right now I'm on the board still, and I'm also chairman of the foundation. And I, for some reason or another, talked to my daughter.
Right.
And she said, maybe they'd like to have those pictures in one of their units on 24, so.
I want to ask you, it's just about a little book I hear Mr. Dick Carter is writing. Tell me something about that.
Well, I have a friend who has newspapers in New York, and he says, I got somebody to write the book for you. We've got setting up plans to do the book and have book signing and let the money go towards the hospital.
Of course, you know I'm going to be there and ask for an autographed copy with my name on it.
Yeah.
You know that.
Yeah,
I
really.
Mean, I want to feel like a celebrity, too.
Yeah, well, so. I don't know about that, but at any rate, that's the way it's being set up.
It sounds wonderful. I want to thank you so much for talking with me, and I want to just wish you all the luck, and I hope you have a sellout show, and it's going to be great. I can't wait to be there.
Thank you so
Thanks
much.
So much. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, thank you. Yeah.